the best in PC gaming and PlayStation gaming. Fresh with uploaded videos, premieres, and live streams all the time. Click the subscribe button to Australia's finest video gaming YouTube channel, GFYS Gaming Australia. Action is pleasure, simulation is key.
Scherger Tower, Nugini 112-3 ready for departure to the east at runway 30.
Nugini 112-3 altimeter 29er decimate 0 and 104-24. East departure approved. Cleared for takeoff runway 30.
Cleared for takeoff runway 30 Nugini 112-3.
Well, g'day, how's it going, viewers, and welcome to GFYS Gaming Australia. What is Microsoft Flight Simulator gameplay on PC here on this Wednesday, the 7th of July, 2021. We're on the real-time date and weather system, and we have an Air Nugini A320neo Airbus Papua New Guinea plane here, ladies and gentlemen. We are actually going to Port Moresby in Papua New Guinea on this trip, ladies and gentlemen, from far north Queensland, and we are classing this as an international flight as we are going to another country. So we hope you enjoy, sit back, relax, as we go to our great neighbours of Papua New Guinea for the first time here at GFYS Gaming Australia with this fantastic new plane design I've gotten. Like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, turn that notification bell on. Like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. Enjoy the flight.
What I turned off there, ladies and gentlemen, is the auto trim. And if you want to take off the auto trim, ladies and gentlemen, you come over here on these A320s, just click on that section 2 and 3, and it'll automatically take it off, and then you have full control on your trim. And on my Airbus joystick, Thrustmaster joystick, I got the right side. If you're a right-handed person, I got the second last button on the front and the last button at the front as the rudders. And they've got a couple of little dots on them. So the one in the middle's got two little dots with the button, and the one on the end's got the little one dot on there. So that's what I use to do auto trim. You can see I've got auto trim on here at the moment, and you can, if you want to take off auto trim, you can easily just do one of those. It is advisable probably to do the trim when you're definitely landing a plane, but it's up to you guys. As you've seen on my last video from Salt Lake City to Denver, you would have seen me crush the plane at the runway. Those really big 747/8s always been giving me problems to land. So if we do trips from on that plane from now on, I'll probably be trying to hopefully master that landing. We're 311 nautical miles to go. We've got a long way to go, folks. This international flight, we're almost over the Pacific Ocean now. We've had to come from the opposite side, like further closer to the Northern Territory border. And down here, folks, it gives you the, as you can see, I've put GFYS there. You can see the time, you can see the date there. It is the 7th today, so it's got 17 written on there, but we all know it's the 7th. Gives you the data, and that gives you that. You can program that in if you like. This gives you the fuel, all that stuff, airport. Waypoint. And all that stuff, and clear that. Working quite fine there. So you can see now I've put GFYS Gaming Australia in there, so we know where we are. It's pretty cool actually. I sort of haven't worked out how to work those, but I've been seeing this Mexican guy on Facebook. Been sort of following him. He's been doing really fantastic stuff. As we go to the tropical North Queensland, the Great Barrier Reef down there, we're at 24,390 altitude, over 24,000. we got to, to go over the ocean here very shortly. It's easier allocation where we are. So we come over from over here. We're at the top of North Queensland here, ladies and gentlemen. At the top of Queensland, we're about to fly over the water here. So we're technically over the water now. You can see the beautiful water down there, ladies and gentlemen. Say goodbye to Australia, ladies and gentlemen. Back a little bit. This is going to stay down, the engine's going to drop a little bit while we do lose the speed. We want to back off that speed a little bit there, get those flaps down in the middle. Couple little islands down there, nothing really major. See how beautiful the water is down there, folks. It's just absolutely stunning. Look how beautiful it is. You can't beat Queensland, folks. It is a stunning place. I've been at North Queensland before, folks, from the start of Great Barrier Reef as far as a place called 1770 Angus Waters. It's where Captain Cook went to get some water before he actually came down to Sydney. So it's named after that, 1770 Angus Waters. Beautiful place. It was sort of getting developed when I was up there, and I'm like, I hope this place doesn't get developed anymore, because this is an absolute paradise place. I've never seen water in real life so absolute crystal clear, like baby blue. It was beautiful. Such white sand. Absolutely stunning. bit of a storm out at sea, folks. Let's just see the lightning bolt just there. like driving these Airbus A320 Neros. Very, I don't know, they're a bit easier to drive than what the really big boys are. But yeah, I don't know, the really big ones are just very strong for me. Very hard to control. Not so much in taking off and going in the and being in the air with them. It's just the landing on them. Even still struggle a fair bit with these ones. But as you've seen, if you have been watching our gameplay, you can see that I've landed these boys as well a fair lot of times. So I do apologize if we do crash this plane at the end, folks, but we're giving you a trip anyway. As long as we get to the runway, that counts. So if we crash it, then don't blame me, folks. It's only a simulation. It's not a real life scenario. Beautiful looking plane, I really enjoy it. I only get the finest detailed planes, folks, ones that I love to see. So this Papua New Guinea one was under, I wrote Australia, and then I put it under A320s, and yeah, this come up on there, and I'll through the flight.sim page I go through, so it was pretty cool. You can see there's not a soul in sight. Got 222 nautical miles to go.
1123 contact port Moresby center on 118.1.
Going to 118.1 to Genie. 1123.
Canada to Genie. That's what we are. So we're going into Port Moresby now.
Port Moresby center.
Okay,
to Genie.
Port Moresby now. So we're in Papua New Guinea communications now.
Now you're Genie 1123 Port Moresby center. Continue as planned.
But not saying that they continue to the plan.
Continue with plan, yeah.
Okay. So we must be far enough now over the ocean to actually have that open. Bring that up. We're still more than halfway to go. I'll bring that up now, ladies and gentlemen, so you guys got a rough idea. You see Port Moresby there, that is where we are going. So we are more than half, we are less than halfway over the ocean between Australia, North Queensland, Australia, and Papua New Guinea, Port Moresby. We've got unlimited fuel supply. That's why it stays at 50. Have a look at the Going very nicely indeed. We hope you're enjoying this so far, ladies and gentlemen. If you're watching this on the Premiere, 1080p at 60 frames per second, and when fully processed, will be uploaded to 1440p at 60 frames per second. Okay, you can see that we're pretty much almost halfway across the water now. And on the other side of the water, Port Moresby's right on the edge, so we're 150 nautical miles to go. Going quite well, actually. We're cruisy. Here we go, there's some cloud here. There might be some storming, that I'm not too sure. We approach 25,000. Pretty puffy, that.
Moresby Center, Nagini, 1123. Request clearance to transition Charlie Airspace.
Now you're denied 1123 Port Moresby Center. Cleared through the Charlie Airspace.
Okay.
Cleared through Charlie Airspace, Nagini, 1123.
Okay, apparently the weather is hazy right now in Port Moresby. So we're going to have some cloud around. You can see that anyway from where we are here. You can see it's a bit hazy, cloudy. So it's going to be an interesting landing. 119 nautical miles to go. We are closer now to Papua New Guinea. More than halfway on this trip. By the way, folks, this is our first official international flight for 2021 here from us here at GF West Gaming Australia, as we just got back into the game in June after a long layoff, not being able to download the game because of the size of it, and also not being able to work on my old PC, which we now have. We've now moved from the 1060 to the 1650. Back doing this international flight, but yeah, when we started getting the game back up and going again, we were on the 1060 with my now old gaming PC, and now I'm with the new gaming PC, as the other one had a meltdown. So we're doing quite well here, folks. 100 nautical miles almost to go now. Thumbs up on it. 93, nautical miles to go. 92. It was 93. It was 93. Should be able to get that up there now. Because we're over the water. Should get an auto on this one. We'll see when we get closer. You'll notice, folks, that there'll be editing in this video, ladies and gentlemen. I've had to edit my pauses in the game. I ran out of memory on one of my hard drives along the trip, because the D drive's been filled up with all the mods and stuff that I've got for the flight game. So I'm using my starter deck portable with my 2 terabyte from my old computer. I pulled out the hard drives and all that from the old computer and whatever I could salvage. So got those backing me up and putting the videos up through there now. So yeah, I've had to split this video into two parts, but when I've been recording this, but it will be all fully polished and edited for you guys that are watching us right now. I think I can hear some thunder, so there might be some storms over the top underneath us here. So we're coming closer now to the end of this trip. Whoa, okay, we see a rainbow and there's definitely some rain about. So much for them, it's supposed to be just a mist. Let's have a look at the current weather. Okay, folks, we're going into this thunderstorm.
Sydney Tower, the GD1123 is 19 miles west 2,400 feet with that note to land.
The GD1123 port, Moresby Tower. Altimeter, 29.74 wind 153 at 22. Enter left down wind runway 32 right.
Fly left downwind runway 32 right Nagini 1123.
Okay, folks, we're in Papua New Guinea now, and first time we've come here, and man, what a way to come here. Big thunderstorm. Doesn't seem to see where we are at the moment. We seem to be flying everywhere where there's a bloody storm, eh? There's been a fair few of them. Do apologise for the lag if you see that, folks. Okay, so we're now officially over Port Moresby. Here we are. There's a bit of a village down there.
1123 wind 153 at 22. Clear to land runway 32 right.
Clear to land runway 32 right Nagini 1123.
We landed. Man, we landed in a bloody thunderstorm. So much fun saying, oh, it's hazy. It's fucking storming. Man.
Taxiing to gate 3 via taxiway Alpha Charlie Nagini 1123.
coming down, I'll tell you right now.
Woo!
Ah! It's coming down big time. We're going blown into a thunderstorm. Whoa, let's see that ball. Alright, let's put those parking brakes on. Shut those engines down. And get those ground services.
Port Moresby Ground, the GD1123. Could you please connect the jetway to the aircraft?
The GD1123, the jetway is going to be connected.
Okay.
Port Moresby Ground, the GD1123. Could you please send the baggage?
Genie, 1123, we don't know where the baggage is. The baggage is lost. We're gonna get it, find out
again. Moresby Ground, the Genie 1123, could you please send the baggage?
Genie, 1123, we don't know where the baggage is.
Someone started on the flight. They don't want to come out, it's bloody too strong, it's bloody... Oh my god. Alright. Let's go back in the in-cab view and get this thing shut down. There we go. Right, there we go. Thank you very much, North Queensland flight, ladies and gentlemen, to Papua New Guinea in Port Moresby, ladies and gentlemen, and very nicely done indeed with this international flight with this Papua New Guinea Airways plane that you've seen. Very nice. Like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, turn that notification bell on, and like us at Facebook and follow us at Twitter. And check out our Microsoft Flight Simulator playlist today for other international flights, domestic flights, flight tours, and much, much more. Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you on our next flight. Hooroo.